Hello and welcome back to some Expert Raid Arena games. We are on a Persian war here between Unexpected in blue. Unexpected, apparently, if you believe AOC sound, is Monoz. Monoz? I don't know. I'm not gonna call him Monoz because I can't pronounce like Spanish, Portuguese, whatever. Mexican if you want. So, Monoz in blue and Fedex, very well known arena player in red. Two of the best. Argentinian players out there, I think, and I've seen a thread recently on AOC, so on a little poll, who's the best, Argentinian player, not sure what the results were, or if it's still going, but those two are at least in the top 5, top 10, I guess, top 5, I'm not sure how good Monoz is or was before. Fedex is a very strong player, I guess they're in the top 5, so let's see what players are going to do here. Persian War should be interesting, not a typical arena civilization, but in a mirror war, anything can happen, of course. And I'm gonna start here with the Monoz map, who's playing blue, is player 1, so let's start with him. Got 2 deer, 3, 4 deer inside, 1 boar inside, where's the second boar? It's inside as well. The main gold on the side, forward somehow, a little bit trapped in the forest, maybe a TC here later on would be good. But it's okay-ish, I guess. Main stone forward, it's not nice, but nothing that the players aren't used to. Second gold very safe in the back, and an extra gold safe in the back, that's a little bit of a compensation here. And second stone outside, third gold actually inside as well, quite forward, but he could take it here, Monoz, without having to worry about like the scouts or knights coming in. So actually not the worst map for him, it's okay. Boris there, very nice lure here. Fedex saying no, 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 no. What's happening to him? Oh, I guess the villager just took a sheep here. not the best multitasking, but not too late. Now taking the sheep harvesting, to say harvested. This is happening, he's abandoning it right now. I'm actually not sure what is better, to take the sheep or to leave it alone and let it rot while you're taking the boar, no idea. Maybe someone can find out. We have an extra Versi on the left hand side, we have two relics really close, and this one actually is still closer to Monoz at the same time. Two wolves here, there's an extra gold on the map. This might be an extra stone, we'll check later on. And the other extra gold we've seen already, that's in Monoz base. So let's go for Fedex now. Fedex got one relic close, two relics close to his base. He's got the main gold on the side, kind of forward, but a little bit better, I guess, than Monoz. Main stone also forward, second gold outside, and this leaves the third gold inside and the second stone inside, along with 3-4 deer, which Fedex is luring already. Having a lot of villagers, 10 villagers on the boar, which actually makes sense. Get 6 on sheep and 4 on deer should be fine, maybe 3 on deer, and move some villagers to somewhere else later on. We are on 21 population for both players. Scouting, I think everybody scouted around his base, and Monoz just missed the extra gold on his map. I guess he sent a sheep there, he's going for a deer right now. Sorry, I had to sneeze. I didn't want you to hear that one, so I muted myself for a second here. And we see barracks coming up for Monoz here. Going up to field a little bit earlier than Fedex. 24 population only. Fedex is on 26, got 3 farms up. Looks like he doesn't want to go for barracks, or maybe he will and I'm just not building it yet. He's got enough wood for it, that's sure. And sending villagers, now he's sending 2 villagers to build the barracks, getting the last deer in. It's not the last one actually, but will be the last. Barracks up a little bit late, but it will be alright. Stable coming up for him as well as the blacksmith. Stable and blacksmiths up for Monoz as well. And both players are gonna go scouts, maybe spears, maybe knights even. A little bit of walling coming up in front of the main gold here, very smart play already. 5 villagers on berries, nothing special here, 5 farms for Monoz, it's gonna be up a little bit earlier of course. And Fedex doing now 3 plus 5, that's 8 farms for him already. But nobody going for... Monoz going for scouts, Fedex has to go away right now. Fedex not doing scouts, he's going for 1. And he's gonna be able to take down Monoz scout pretty easily now. TC could help, no, not happening, Monastery coming up for Fedex. Let's go for Monoz base, what is he doing? Monastery is up and he should be able to secure those 3 relics if he could had seen them. No, he can't see them actually, he needs to scout a little bit more. And is he doing TCs right now? Doesn't have the wood for it. Of course he went up really early, so it's a little bit hard to do that. Also going for a lot of houses already. something that he doesn't need. 33 villages and going for 50 pop, but okay, you don't want to get housed. Fedex on the other hand going for TC on the woodline and main gold, really nice one. He's gonna go for 3 TCs at least, I guess. 4 scouts out in play for Monoz here. Fedex has to go away. But these two both are injured. And Monoz is gonna go for the relics now. He should be able to grab those two. Because he's got a lot of scouts there. Let's see, is Fedex. Yeah, got a scout here. But shouldn't get a conversion. And not sure what Monoz is doing right now. He's gonna lose this monk, I'm pretty sure, because no sanctuary done, and oh, the monk survived, look at this, that's amazing actually, pretty lucky there, my opinion, but his scouts were fast enough, grabbing one relic, he's gonna try and grab the other relic. Fedex is gonna have no relics here in this game, unless he's gonna find those later on before Monoz can. I think that's not going to happen. Monoz now should think about, there we go, second TC coming up for him, and he's gonna go for 3 TCs most likely. Doing horse color only now, but it's okay, I guess. He's gonna have 5 relics, that's really a good compensation for late horse color here. And Fedex not daring to go out. Fedex, do you see Fog of War? I think he could see the relic being taken. And now Monoz has to search for more relics, he's gonna find all of them. While Fedex is gonna be booming happily of 3 TCs for now, because this one just finishing, there we go, for 4k8 HP, just really nice for the Persians, of course. One more scout is out for Fedex actually, but Monoz has seen it already and is gonna hunt it down. I think he should send 2 scouts to go to the left hand side, but the monks are gonna do the scouting as well. One villager moving forward, maybe we're gonna see Siege Workshop or something like that. It's a possibility, of course. Fedex using the monk here, yeah, house being started here. Fedex should be able to spot this if he's keeping the monk close to the walls. And now Monoz can see the next 2 relics. Where's the last one? Last one is here, actually 2-3 tiles maybe, but he's only gonna find it later on. Instead he's gonna focus on this little forward here. 3 TCs actually, so the forward won't be too strong probably, but 200 wood and 200 gun, that's a siege workshop. There we go. 53 against 48 villagers. Fedex is looking okay-ish for now. I guess he's got a pretty good boom going at 22 minutes. It's not a pure, not a full boom, of course, because we could see the... we have a stable here and... Ooh, interesting, lumber camp. Stables is up and few scouts were out of play. But a pretty good boom incoming. Now is a knight on the field for Monoz. And I think Monoz should go for knights now, if he really wants to push here. At the same time, ooh, knight being converted, expected here, of course, that's gonna go really fast, and the mangonel might go down as well, which is not good. Mangonel down, the knight is still alive, of course, 1 HP, and good attack. Ooh, that's 2, that's 1 monk, getting 1 knight and 2 mangonels, effectively, and now there's the mangonel up for Fedex as well. Monoz not with a good trade here, and Fedex is gonna start a wall a little bit, I guess, maybe with buildings here, and defend with 2 mangonels, of course, no redemption for Persians, the monks are just not too strong, and Fedex has clicked up to Imperial Age, he's on 79 population at 76 villages. He should be fine. Pikeman research coming in immediately. And Monoz at the same time. 1, 2, 3 TCs. Going for market right now. Probably wants to go up to Imperial Age 2. And no, oh, nice fights here for Monoz this time. I missed the 2 mangonels going down on the second one. But Fedex not with a very good micro, I guess. Maybe a little bit unlucky. This house will go down really fast. And now Monoz can go in. Let's go for Fedex point of view. What can he see? He can see the scouts move forward, the 3 mangonels. He's got mangonels and knights in the stable here, also producing pikemen already. Second barracks is up. And Imperial Age done for Fedex. Monoz just now clicking up. Let's see what Fedex is going to do. Good resources. I think he should maybe do Cavalier at this point if he wants to fight back. But for now, only knight production. A lot of resources and not doing anything with it here. I'm not sure why Fedex isn't researching anything. More barracks coming up, so we might see the help upgrade. Yep, there we go. And blacksmith plus one defense fortune coming in. So we're gonna see the standard trash for Persians. We're gonna see helps. We might see elite skirmishes later on, but most likely it's gonna be hand carniers. Paladin is unlikely, maybe Hussars if the game is going longer. And Siege Ram, yep, kept from on the way. Siege Ram is an upgrade that I really want to get. Monoz with this little forward being declined for now, but he's on the way to Imperial Age as well. Almost the same religion number, so not really a big difference. Siege workshops coming up at home. Art Revenges, we're gonna see the hand cannoneers most likely. I don't think he's gonna go for elite skirmish at this point. Only later on those should come in. Imperial Age is done, and where's the chemistry upgrade? We have a university chemistry coming in immediately. There we go. We might see Capron for him as well. Not sure yet. Siege workshop coming up for Fedex now. In a very forward position. Also Fedex doing chemistry a little bit later. Doesn't really matter. Fedex laughing because he lost this Manganel. Very nice shot here from Monoz. And the little forward is going to go down. TC on the outside gold here for Fedex as well. That's a very good choice. And players are going to keep booming a little bit, getting more religious. Iron casting chemistry hand card on the way for Fedex now. Very nice upgrades. And Fedex in a very commanding position, but the score lead, not really a big difference here. And we are going to see a little bit of a mid-Imperial Age fight, I guess. I don't think this is going to be over really soon. 22 military events against 3 only for Monoz. But Monoz got at least 6 archer ranges up, so hand carnier production will be strong for him. And I think he started right now. Oh, look at this. A lot of hand carniers being queued up. And we see bombard cannons at the same time, so gunpowder... gunpowder power here? Yeah, probably. Hand cannoneers and bomber cannons in play. Cap rams with helps inside them. And the helps, although they're not really strong against the hand cannoneers, they can do the damage, at least to the bomber cannons, if there are enough, if there's enough of them. Also, the knights, maybe cavalier, would be a very nice choice here at this point. Problem is they're easily countered. That's why usually players don't go for them unless there is a little window of opportunity, let's call it like this. And now we have a fight here between bombard cannons, which are out for Fedex as well. Capram will go down, and the hand cannon is at this point really strong. Of course, Fedex acting fast, doing 6 archer ranges of his own, is gonna get hand cannon production going as well. No upgrades for Fedex, plus 1 defense for Monoz here. The 4 relics inside the monastery are out because the monastery is gone. I think Monoz should rebuild the monastery maybe somewhere in the back and get the relics in. It would be very nice and helpful. Don't know how long he can take his main goal, but he's able to defend here. Same amount of military units, roughly a lot of bombard cannons out. That's actually 6 bombard cannons. Wow, that's huge for Monoz, and he should be able to take all the buildings down with that striking power here. Look at this, 7 bomber cannons already. The siege workshop's going down really fast. Nice micro here from the hand cannoneers, trying to get down the hand cannon, the bomber cannon as well. And Fedex has to go back. Wow, look at this attack here, beautiful. Oh, I would like to see this more often. Lately, not too many arena games, expert arena games have been played, or at least I didn't see them. I was happy to see that. Oh god, I can't pronounce his name. And I see someone. He's posting a lot of games from the Chinese community, and I think he posted those. Games too, so kudos here. Very nice game already between Monoz and Fedex here, and this push is really strong. Oh, there's 40 against 33 military units. Now Fedex, I think, has enough units to try and fight back. Halberdiers has a meat shield, and then the bombard cannons need to take good care of the hand carniers, I think. Ooh, actually, almost bombard cannon going down. I think one went down. I'm just not sure why. I don't know when actually. Now stables coming up, bloodlines. I think we're gonna see the transition into hussars, and maybe helps for Monoz later on as well. Hand cannoneers are gonna take down a lot of halberdiers here. Yeah, one nice micro. But Fedex also 5 bomber cannons, so the push from Monoz is stopped. Very nice. And now it's gonna come down to micro. Villagers 119 against 112, so very, very equal here. Ah, nice shots on those halberdiers, oh man, and those two damn bastards, the damn unlucky bastards. Fedex trying to fight back, and I think it's now gonna be a matter of trash units. Fedex is throwing a lot more units at Monoz here, and I think he can distract him like this. And yeah, Hellbit is going forward. That's the point where Fedex is moving his bombard cannons, trying to micro them. And a few micro bombard cannons going down from Monoz. He's lost like 3 at this point in the game. 5, sorry, at this certain point. My voice going down again, damn it. Ah, yeah. And Fedex rebuilding his archer ranges, but a lot of bombard cannons went down, and Fedex still has 3, so he lost 2 at least. But he managed to stop the push. Very nice defense here for Fedex. Light Cav and Chain Barding are coming in for Monoz here. What is Fedex doing actually? Does he have a stable 1, I think? That's the only one, so he's not gonna go for Hussars at any time soon. He's got the Halberdier, so maybe he's gonna stick with those. But in the long term, Hussars will be very, very useful. In the long run, Castle now coming up for Fedex here. Probably wants to get the conscription upgrade. Not sure if Monoz has one. No, apparently not. And Fedex now with 7 bombard cannons of his own. Gotta get those buildings down really fast. See, nice micro here. A lot of units. I'm gonna look slower right now because I want to see who is losing how many bombard cannons here. 7 against. Ooh, nice shot here from Monoz. Fedex only on 4. But nice side moving, losing another one. Monoz losing one. Now he's sending the light cav out. Probably take the bomber cans down, and this one is some very low HP. That's so difficult to tell. Ah, damn. My throat. I can't really talk. Not as much as I would like to. That's gonna be a little bit of a slower game for me. Light cap moving in, going down really fast. Monoz with a lot more bomber cannons right now. And Fedex lost quite a good amount of gold here in this fight. Monoz trying to fight back. Does Monoz have castle up? 516. No, he's gonna get it up very soon. Still hasn't found this gold. He's gonna find it later on, I think. If the game is going that long. Not sure if anybody found the gold on the left hand side. Monoz missed it by a tile or two. Fedex didn't even scout the left edge. So for now they're just fighting. Not sure if anybody's taking a lot of gold inside their bases. No, outside taking gold. And Monoz should be able to take the gold inside. Yeah, he's got a good, he had good gold spots. Unless you're being rushed, of course, but Persians rushing is really hard. Fedex now doing conscription, expected here. Population 193 against 153, so Fedex a lot more units on the field. 20 more villagers, 20 more military units. And resources for Monoz stockpiling a little bit, at least on the wood line. And should get a castle up maybe in front of the stables, would be really nice. Nice position here, protecting his army. Actually going in front of the 2 resources, that's even better. In front of the gold and stone here. Fight still going in the middle, no fightings on the sky, no fights on the side here. No secret forwards or anything. Elite skirmisher thumbing and fletching coming in for Monoz right now. Wants to have something against both hand carriers and halberdiers, and of course elite skirmishers. Now that's later on in the game. Are a good choice here. Double siege workshop coming up for Fedex. I think he has not done siege ram, and for now he's not doing rams. We see, oh my god, look at this. 8, 9 bombard cannons out in play for Monoz. Those cost so much gold. That's 2k gold already, on the field. And Fedex has a problem. The castle will go down pretty fast. What did he say? Start the game already. Not sure if they had a pause. Fedex, of course, having his own bomber cannons. I think that's like 7 of them. And nice fight here. 60 military units for both players. A lot of bullets flying back and forth. Bomber cannon going down for Fedex. One down for Monoz. Castle being repaired by Fedex now. And both players are losing a lot of units. Not sure who has a better position here, but Monoz got more military units out. So, and the castle almost down, so it looks like he's in the better position at this point. Fedex right now researching siege ram, which is a very important upgrade, and I think in the long run it's the better one. Castle is down. A little bit of a victory here for Monoz. He's in a score lead. Fedex trying to defend. Nice. Taking down the bombard cannon. A little split here. He's gonna lose a few hand carriers. But all the bombard cannons actually went down. Good job for Fedex here. two more from Monoz on the field. Fedex also doing the elite skirmish upgrade. Gold is getting this so-called scarce. Rare, it's going low for both players. Let's call it like this. Monoz should have the four relics, he only took two. I'm not sure where the Monoz 3 is. And for now, Monoz is the one who's pushing. Looking good for him, actually. 50 minutes into the game, Plate Barding are coming in for Monoz now as well. Fedex trying to get more units out. He's on 46 against 55. He actually should have more units on the field, but Monoz somehow with the better fights. I think the bomber cannons taking down the castle was a key moment at this game, and if he's winning from here, then it's because Fedex wasn't able to really defend his castle and defend his forward. Castle now coming up, second castle for Monoz in a very forward position, in range of those buildings, which is very good for him. Fedex not doing siege ramps anywhere. I think that's a unit that's missing right now. Lead skirmisher production is going, but not enough in my opinion. And while Fedex trying to go with the sneaky forward right now, Monoz should be able to defend. Maybe should re-wall here. Villager just taking down the siege ramp, and Monoz in a very commanding position in the middle. He's got almost total map control. Elite skirmishers moving forward, the bombard cannons and hand cannoneers in the back. No more light cav on the field, or at least not too many. He doesn't really need them. I think Fedex should have switched into light cav before. He's doing elite skirmishers no helmet gears at this point. They're really pretty much worthless here against that army. And a few light cav on the left hand side. Fedex only now doing the light cav upgrade. And question is, can anybody go for hussars? Do you have enough gold? Doesn't look like it for now. The captrams moving forward here for Monoz, who is researching siege ram expected. He got a lot of food in the bank, now he's using it. And the siege ramps and bombard cannons, this should not turn into Fedex's favor anymore. It looks like Monoz might be able to take the game from here. A few villagers on the front building in yet another castle, securing them the forward here, securing those defending those units, those elite skirmishers and hand cannoneers. One trap is out, sea tram is done for Monoz. Fedex now doing blast furnace and scale barding armor, but he might be a little bit too late. At the same time, Monoz also got more military units on the left-hand side, 87 actually. Very nice, he got only got 109 villagers, but that means he can do more and more military units as long as he actually can afford them. If Fedex can defend from this, then Monoz will run into problems, because Fedex eventually will get more units out. Monoz needs to win this from here, otherwise just this could be hard for him. Got three relics in now, maybe three in the monastery, so he's got a good gold income. Let's go for Fedex resources. Oh, he's very low on everything, look at this. And yeah, only got 50 military units. It's actually not a bad number, but it's not enough to defend from this. And I think Fedex doesn't have any siege anymore. It's a big problem, because he's fighting against gold units, he's fighting against hand cannoneers, bombard cannons, and he needs siege ramps for himself. Light cav, halberdiers, elite skirmishers, all the trash that you can get. Not fully upgraded, but still the trash army. Can't really do anything against the siege ramps, or at least not too much without taking huge damage. And we're almost 1 hour into the game. Monoz is knocking on Fedex walls. More siege workshops coming up for him, but Fedex really doesn't look like he can recover. His eco is okay-ish, I guess. Doesn't have gold, and without gold this could end really fast. Nice snipe, the trebuchet here, one bombard cannon going down, but the trap might go down really soon too, and I think it's time for Fedex to resign here. Monoz with a very strong performance, he got rid of a forward here, the outpost won't really bother him. What a halberdier, my favorite unit of course, because he is gonna destroy that stable in 150-200 years maybe. Yeah, hero unit of course, and at the same time at home, the halberdier, really offensive unit, is not gonna care. Oh, too bad, he's an aggressive and gonna go down. Hero's fallen, 1 hour into the game, and I think Fedex won't be able to come back. Hussar is done for Monoz, and the siege workshop won't go up, the bombard cannons won't go down, and Fedex is still trying to recover, to defend from this, to get more units out. But Monoz with a very strong forward. Now doing more defense. Oh, that's very nice. Does he do more? Oh, only the one. That's too bad. Doesn't have to go for it. But he wants to show Fedex, hey boy, this game is over. I'm doing more defense right now. Please go for one more. Go for one more. I want to see more war defense on the field. This is actually quite funny to see. Oh, please go into the skirmishes. This is going to be devastating. These skirmishes will go down really fast. No tremble damage, or at least not too much, but take down the board defender with lead skirmish. I think there's a video on YouTube. It's gonna take forever. Look at this, Monoz, very, very strong here. Very good game for him, and Fedex saying Jorge, I'm not sure what that's, but maybe it means GG, it's possible. Monoz answering GG, and there we go. Fedex resigned, very, very strong game, more than 1 hour, very nice Persian war here, we've seen a lot of different units. Monoz going for gunpowder and going for bomber cannon, sand cannoneers at the start, then adding elite skirmishers and siege rams, very nice. Hussars, of course, very helpful at this point. I hope you enjoyed this game, and see you on the next one. GG.